Dear students, one more concept under applications of CFT. Factors influencing fitting of the orbital. Often, is fitting of the orbitals increasing? How it is decreasing? What are the factors influencing fitting of the orbitals? Nothing but delta O value or delta T value. How it is influenced? Let us discuss what are the actual factors. First one, same metal ions with different charges. Right? Same metal ion with different charges. Now, Fe H2O6 plus 2, Fe H2O6 plus 3. Right? Same metal ion with different charges. Lesser the charge, lesser the splitting. Greater the charge, greater the splitting. So you can easily understand here less delta O are splitting, you see, high delta O are splitting. Less delta O, high delta O. Same metal with different charges, greater the charge density, greater the oxidation number, greater will be splitting. Coming to the next. Second, different metal ions, different charges, provided electronic configuration is same. So you have to take electronic configuration into consideration. Here, same metal ions, the charge is different according to the charge you are deciding. Here, different metal ions, different charges, provided electronic configuration is same. Now, you consider, look here, vanadium H2O6 plus 2. Come on, next one. H2O6 plus 3. Okay. Now, different charges we agree. Metal ions are different, charges are different. But configuration we should see. Same configuration. Come on, vanadium plus 2, D3. Chromium plus 3, come on, D3. The following. What a concept I am giving. Different metal ion with different charges, provided the configuration is same. Once configuration is same, don't depend on the configuration. See the charge or oxidation number. Similarly, now less charge density, less delta O. Less charge density, come on, less delta O. High charge density, high delta O. High delta O. So lesser the charge density, less. Higher the charge density, high. The simplest way to identify whenever two complexes are given, which is having greater delta O, which is having lesser delta O, higher delta O and lesser delta O, you can understand. Come on, students, from these two concepts, what you can understand? Charge density directly proportional to splitting. No, charge density directly proportional to splitting of the orbitals. Charge density directly proportional to splitting of the orbitals. Simplest way to understand the splitting, how it is influenced. Coming to the third one, different metal ions but same charge. Charge is same, you cannot decide based on the charge. Here, charge is different, more charge, more. Charge is different, more charge, more. What I am saying, next one, different metal ions but same charge, provided electronic configuration different. Look the board. What I am saying, different metal ions, same charge. Look here, C4H2O6 plus 2 Ni H2O6. See, metal ions are different. but charges also different. If here charge is different, but here metallions are different, charge is same. Based on charge you cannot decide now. But charge is same, splitting should be same. But you have to say at the same time electronic configuration. What I am saying, different metallions, same charge, provided electronic configuration is different. Come on, cobalt plus 2, come on, say D7. Nickel plus 2, with the gold, D8. Says configuration is different now. It may be same charge, you cannot decide based on the charge. Charge is same, splitting should be same. But at the same time, you have to see configuration. Now, what is D7? What is water? D8. Therefore, less than the number of electrons, greater than splitting. Less than the number of electrons, greater than splitting. Look here, high delta O, high splitting. High delta O, high splitting. Less delta O, less splitting. Less delta O, less splitting. How to understand this? How to explain this? How to understand, how to explain this particular factor? Look here now. Now, here I am developing a conceptor. How to decide this one? The charge is same, you have to see the configuration. Based on configuration, how to decide it? Now, here, one, you are saying cobalt plus 2, come on. Next one, nickel plus 2. Now, it is what D7, it is what D8. Come on. A cyanide ligand has to form a bond. Following, a cyanide ligand has to form a bond with cobalt plus 2. Similarly, a cyanide ligand has to form a bond with a cyanide ligand has to form a bond with a nickel plus 2. A cyanide is forming a bond with cobalt plus 2. A cyanide is forming a bond with what, nickel plus 2. In such case, yeah, the cyanide is actually experiencing repulsion from, experiencing repulsion from 7 units of negative charge. 7 units of negative charge. Here, the same cyanide experiencing repulsion from 8 units of negative charge. 8 units of negative charge. So that they are experiencing less repulsion, 7 units, with more repulsion, 8 units. Therefore, the cyanide ion in cobalt plus 2, cyanide ion in cobalt plus 2 can penetrate much nearer to the root of the metal ion. Fine. Cyanide ion in cobalt plus 2 can penetrate much nearer to the nucleus, much nearer to the nucleus of the metal ion. Once it is penetrating much nearer to the nucleus of the metal ion, then it can cause more splitting. Here, cyanide ion cannot penetrate much nearer to the nickel plus 2. Therefore, it is little away, it is little near, therefore it is causing more splitting. Therefore, from this particular concept, less the number of electrons, more splitting, more the number of electrons, less splitting. Now we can develop a concept here. What concept? Number of electrons in d orbitals. Number of electrons in d orbitals. Fine. Number of electrons in d orbitals. Inversely proportional to splitting. Number of electrons in d orbitals. Inversely proportional to splitting. More the electron, less splitting. Less electrons, more splitting. Cobalt plus 2, 7 electrons. Right? Cyanide is actually experiencing repulsion from 7 units of negative charge. It can penetrate much nearer to the cobalt plus 2. Similarly, in the second case, nickel plus 2, 8. The cyanide in the nickel plus 2 experiencing 8 units of negative charge. Repulsion from 8 units. It cannot penetrate much. Once it is penetrating much near, causing more splitting. Therefore, number of electrons in d orbital inverse to delta O. Next, fine. Same metal ions, different charges. Different metal ions, different charges. Here charge is different, you can easily decide. Here charge is same. Based on number of electrons, we are deciding the splitting. Coming to the next one, fourth, quantum number, look the board, quantum number. See, 3D to 4D, 4D to 5D, 3D to 4D, 4D to 5D, down the group, 3D to 4D, 4D to 5D, that splitting of d orbitals increase, splitting of d orbitals increase. Look here, now I am giving C4, x2 rotating 6, plus 3. Come on, say, below cobalt, what is the metal? You should remember all the elements perfectly, then only you can easily answer this type of questions. complete periodic table, you should know all the 118 elements, their location, their atomic number, their configuration, everything. Then only you can master the subject. That's very difficult. So, Dilokoval, rhodium. Therefore, come on, say rhodium H2O taken 6. H2O taken 6. Come on, +3. One more I am giving. Come on, below rhodium, what is the element? Below cobalt, rhodium. Below rhodium, what is the element? Can you say? Come on. So, remember the elements are very difficult. Iridium. Iridium, H2O, taken 6. Iridium, H2O, taken 6. H2O, taken 6. Iridium, H2O, taken 6. Plus. 3D to 40, 40 to 50, gradually delta values increase. It was given in some of the books, the 3D to 40 nearly 40% increase. And 40 to 50 nearly 50% increase, we observe the delta values. Delta values gradually. Delta values gradually increase. Look here, delta values gradually increase. Delta values gradually increase from top to the bottom. 3D to 40, 40 to 50 gradually increase. Can you say why increase? Can you say why increase? Now you see, recollect our atomic structure. As the quantum number increase, you know that the quantum number increase, the energy difference between the orbitals, energy difference between the orbits is decreasing. The quantum number is increasing, energy difference between the orbits is decreasing. As a result, the ligands are near to the 4D orbitals and 5D orbitals. As a result, the effect on the ligand, the effect of ligand on the d orbitals, the 5D will be more, 4D will be more, and less will be on 3D. Therefore, 3D to 4D, 4D to 5D, the quantum number is increasing, and splitting of the orbitals increase. As the quantum number is increasing, the energy difference between the orbits is decreasing. As a result, the ligand is near to the higher energy orbits. Therefore, the ligand is causing more effect. As a result, 3D to 4D, 4D to 5D, gradually delta values increasing. Next one more, fifth point. Look here. Fifth one, field strength. Easy to understand. Field strength. Field strength. Field strength. You hope you know very well, ligands are classified into two sets, strong field ligand and weak field ligand. Yes, weak field ligand is causing less splitting, but strong field ligand is causing more splitting. Weak field ligand is causing less splitting, strong field ligand is causing more splitting. Easy to understand. So, field strength directly proportional to splitting. A strong field ligand is actually causing greater splitting of the orbitals, weak fields is causing lesser splitting of the orbitals. Therefore, field strength directly proportional to splitting of the orbitals. Field strength directly proportional to splitting of the orbitals. Next one. Look here, geometry. We are well discussed all the splitting of d orbitals in different geometries. First I have taken octahedral, then I have taken square planar, then I have taken tetrahedral. Even we have discussed tetragonal splitting, trigonal bipyramidal splitting, and square pyramid splitting. All these splittings are well discussed. What? Octahedral splitting, tetragonal splitting, tetrahedral splitting, and square planar splitting, trigonal bipyramidal splitting, and square pyramid splitting. All these splittings when we have discussed, including these many, let us take only three: square planar splitting, octahedral splitting, and tetrahedral splitting. I hope you remember well. Splitting of d orbitals, consider delta O. This particular splitting of d orbitals in square planar is highest. Square planar followed by octahedral, followed by what? Tetrahedral. Therefore, geometry also playing a role in deciding splitting of d orbital. Then what I am writing is delta SP, come on, more than delta O. Delta O more than delta T. What is the meaning of this one? You take single metal ion, right? Single metal ion. What I am taking? Single metal ion only, and what is the configuration? D8. So, it may be this particular nickel plus 2 with the Di it may be forming a spapenoid complex, a tetrahedral complex, octahedral complex. In all the three splittings of the geometries, the metal ion is got nickel plus 2, configuration for DA. Only the single metal ion, nickel plus 2, and the configuration got DA. Single metal ion, single configuration. But once geometry is differing, splitting also differs. Why splitting differs, we have discussed very well the splitting of d orbitals in octahedral, spapenoid, tetrahedral. Therefore, even though single metal ion, same electronic configuration, based on the geometry of the complex, the splitting is differing. Delta Y is always more than delta. Delta SP. Delta SP is always more than delta O. Delta O is always more than delta delta T. This is order of splittings of orbitals in different geometries. Next, coming to one point, I'll give a question and I'll try to answer that particular. Here, I'm putting a question to you. What question I'm giving? I'm not giving the multiple choice question. I'm giving five pairs of complexes I'm putting in front of you. Five pairs of complexes. In each complex, according to our discussion, you have to decide which is more, which is less, delta values or splitting. Look at what I'm putting a question to you. Identify the following pairs, which is having greater delta O, which is having greater delta O, which is having greater delta O. Look the word. First one. Look here carefully, what are the points for distance? Accordingly, you have to decide which is more, which is less. 1, and T3, FE, CN, taken 6. Well, look here, second one. Ni, NST, taken 6, and NST taken 6, plus 2, and Ni, NST, taken 4, taken 6 times already here, come on 6, and what I am writing is 6, and what I am writing is plus 4, next 3, CO, NH3, taken 6, plus 3, and CO, CN, taken 6, CO, CN, taken 6, minus 3, CO, CN, taken 6, minus 3, one more I am writing to the board carefully. Now, the fourth one, in each pair, we have to identify which is more, which is less. Coming to the next one, H2O, taken 6, plus 3. And rhodium, H2O, taken 6, plus 3. H2O taken 6, plus 3. The last one is here carefully. Cr NH3 taken 6, plus 2, and look here, Ni NH3 taken 6, plus 2. This is the question. Not the multiple choice question. This is what the question I put in front of you. Five pairs are given to you. In each pair, according to our discussion, whatever I discussed now, based on that, try to understand which is having greater delta O, which is having lesser delta O. Come on, take 2 minutes time and try to understand and do. Come to the first one.
Here K4 F is here taken 6, K3 F is here taken 6.
Everything is same.
Here F is what plus 2, right?
Here F is what plus 3. Greater the charge, greater the splitting. Greater the charge, greater the splitting.
Here plus 2. Here plus 3. This is what plus 2. This is what plus 3. Therefore, what you can understand, the second one is having greater delta wall.
Agreed? Yes. Come into the next one.
Here nickel. And nickel,
everything is same. Here nickel plus 2, here nickel plus 4. It is hexamine. What is differing? Charge is differing. So greater the charge, come on, greater the splitting. So second one is having what a greater. Second one is having what a greater. Coming to the next one. Everything is same. Cobalt plus 3. Here also oxygen number plus 3. Here also oxygen number plus 3. Both are cobalt plus 3, cobalt plus 3. Here amine. Here what extra cyano, hexamine. What is only 6-6? But amine is weaker than Cn minus. Cn minus is stronger than NH3. Therefore, second one. Everything is same, but here field strength. Greater the field strength, greater the splitting. Next, coming to this one. Everything is same here also, right? Cobalt plus 3, rhodium plus 3. Hexa-aqua, hexa-aqua. Plus 3, plus 3. What is the difference? What actual difference you are finding? One is 3D, one is 4D. This one I said to you. 3D to 4D delta values increase. Therefore, this particular rhodium complex is more. Rhodium complex is more. Here, the fifth one confuses you. Look the board. What answer you can answer? What answer you can decide? Everything is same. Hexamine. But it's cobalt plus 2, nickel plus 2. Charge is same. Potassium is same. Hexamine is same. Everything is same. But everything is same. But different metal ions, same charge. You have to see the water configuration. You have to see the configuration. Come on, chromium plus 2, what is the configuration remaining? D4. Nickel plus 2, what is the configuration? Come on, D8. Lesser the electrons, more the splitting. Lesser the electrons, more the splitting. Therefore, the fifth one, answer is first complex, chromium is having what greater delta. This is the way questions are appearing in the entrance examination. You should be very careful. You should be exposed to many different types of questions. You know, you can master the subject. Okay, good luck.